This is Susan Wheelbanks with BlendedInsight.com. I am a holistic and integrative healing arts practitioner, an intuitive, and an energy healer. In this podcast, I share tips, tools, and suggestions that have helped me along my path in hopes of inspiring and helping you along yours. Let's get started with today's podcast topic. Hello, bright and beautiful soul. Thank you so much for joining me on another podcast. And thank you so much to everyone who has wished me beautiful birthday wishes. I sincerely appreciate you from the bottom of my heart. And the fun just keeps on rolling because today is one of my most favorite holidays here in the United States, and I know several other countries celebrate it. It's Valentine's Day. And if you are one of those people that tends to get depressed or down or feeling sorry for yourself on Valentine's Day, stay tuned because hopefully by the end of this podcast, I can shift that for you or help you to get a new awareness where you shifted in yourself. So I don't know if you've ever studied the origins of Valentine's Day, but it really goes back to Roman festival days where they were celebrating the coming of spring. And over the years, it evolved into celebrating romantic love. Here in the United States, it's kind of just evolved to celebrating all love and just friendships. And we have Galentine's things for girlfriends and things like that, you know. And in the schools, when I was growing up and then even when my daughter was little, we would do Valentine's parties where they would exchange little Valentines between little classmates and friends. And I've just always enjoyed it so much. I think it's such a fun holiday. And anytime you are celebrating something collectively, there's more energy because that exchange is going on. So over the years at work, colleagues, we give each other a little candy, and it's just celebrating each other. The highest vibration on the planet is love. So you don't have to be in a relationship to appreciate and enjoy Valentine's Day. And I remember a couple years ago, I posted a podcast and some really angry person that wasn't in a relationship and was desperate for a relationship commented something super ugly on the podcast. Of course, I blocked the person and deleted it. And I thought that is the problem with Valentine's Day is people like that have such a desperate and demented spin on it. Demented's not the right word, but I just can't grab the word. But it's a low vibration. Let me just say that. And so I want to share with you how I've celebrated Valentine's Day over the years and give you some ideas to really make this day a very fun day for yourself and for your loved ones. And I'll tell you, I have been partnered for Valentine's Day and I've been single. And I'll say, when I look back, my most favorite Valentine's Day memories are when I was single. And I think it's because I really have learned over the years about how we partner with others and how to show up as a whole person where you aren't lacking and needing anything. You're simply partnering with someone because you would enjoy their company, but it isn't a desperate energy. Anything that you chase runs. When you are trying to attract something, you draw it in. So you have to really get good at letting go of that desperate energy, because anybody that feels that desperate energy, they run. I mean, animals even do it. I mean, it is a vibrational red flag. And I remember growing up, I would be, you know, when you're young and you're a teenager, or at least when I was young, let me speak for myself. When I was young and I was a teenager, Valentine's Day was more about relationships. So you would see little kids scrambling to try to be in, you know, a dysfunctional relationship that's not going to last because you're just a teenager and what do you know? for Valentine's Day. And I grew up watching this. And so because I'm just a studier and a learner and I'm fascinated by people, I like to observe. And observing my own behavior, I started to just kind of shift out of this. So for Valentine's Day, one of the things that I love, love, love to do is give to people that I love, like my daughter. And lots of times I'll give things to my pets for Valentine's Day. I'll give to myself. Do you know the person that you will be with more in your entire life is yourself? And so we want to be giving from our overflow. So when you are meeting your own needs and you feel whole and complete within yourself, and you can sit with yourself in solitude and enjoy your own company, people are naturally drawn to you because you don't have any desperation or clinginess or need for anyone else. You're perfect, whole, and complete by yourself. So there was a few Valentine's days. When I lived in Texas, we had a grocery store called HEB. And those of you who live in Texas, I love HEB. It's such a great store. The day after Valentine's Day, they would have the most gorgeous flower arrangements that would go on clearance for, I mean, like $6 for 2 dozen roses that are beautiful. And I used to get so excited the day after Valentine's to go and get flowers and candy. I like Russell Stover candy. That's what my dad used to buy growing up. And I know it's probably not the most highest quality candy on earth. I'm a simple girl from Arkansas. That's what I like. So all the hearts, the heart candies and things, all the colors, I just love all of it. So I'd get so excited about that. So for Valentine's Day, over the years, Dr. Wayne Dyer once shared that he would buy the children's Valentine's Day cards and pass them out to strangers, which is amazing. Do little things like giving people that I like just a little candy, something very small, or sending people a text message to say, I hope that you have a really great day. I appreciate you. These, you don't have to be in relationship for this. This is just simple acts of kindness to add to the collective of doing kind things, showing appreciation for yourself and others, celebrating the highest form of love, agape love, divine love. And the more of us that do that, it opens your heart chakra. And when you're opening your heart chakra and you're expanded, you are making more room for divine energy to flow in. And so if you're one of those people that tends to get depressed and feel sorry and pout on Valentine's Day and run down people in good relationships, check yourself. Chickity check yourself before you wreck yourself. That used to be a song a long time ago, I think in the 90s. Anyway, don't do that, because you are just essentially swimming in a vibration that won't ever align you with what you want. If you're jealous and having bitterness towards something, it runs from you. You can't attract it. So use this time to meet your own needs. There was another time when it was so interesting. I had a friend of mine who was a very successful person and was married. And she would essentially expect for her husband to get her something very specific on Valentine's Day that she could go to the store and get for herself. And I used to think to myself, if you tell him exactly what to get you, where is the surprise and where is his creativity and where is the element of joyful giving for him? Because it was a very rigid and structured, and this is what I get, like a controlling type of energy. It was very ugly. And if he didn't do it right, she would get really angry. And I thought, you can't control people. You can't do it. And so if you want it that bad, here's my point. If you want it that bad, get it for yourself. So anything that anyone else does for you is just extra. So Valentine's Day, this is how I've celebrated over the year as a single person. So I will wake up, I will have already planned something for myself for that day. So I'm going to make a delicious meal. I'm going to let other people know how much I care about them. I'm going to spend some time doing some things I love. I've done manicures and pedicures on Valentine's Day. I always get my daughter something to let her know how much I love and appreciate her. And she deserves that. You know, I want her to know that you deserve to, you're a lovable person because you exist, period. And I love you no matter what, even though you get on my nerves really badly because you're a teenager. And it's a very tough and trying time, that age, that this whole age bracket of the teens, and anyone that has teenagers know exactly what I'm talking about. But guess what? I was a teenager once. I was just as irritating, so I get it. But I do things like that. Making meals for myself, taking her out to lunch or dinner or whatever. Doing things that really fill me up. Meditating. I can get in the sauna. I can take a bath if I want to. I can get a massage. And it doesn't have to be on Valentine's Day. It can be the week of Valentine's Day, or a few days before, a few days after. And like I shared before, when I lived in Texas, the day after HEB, or the day after Valentine's Day, I would go to HEB, get flowers, get the Russell Stover candy. You know, oh my gosh, they'd have like these huge heart candies that were like, I don't know, $2, was normally like $15. And not that I need to be eating all that chocolate, but that didn't stop me from going and getting it because I enjoy it. And just doing those types of things. And then if you're really, really wanting to be in a relationship, then you've really got to look at, do you meet your own needs? And are the qualifications that you expect in another present in yourself. And I know I've done other podcasts about this, but for me, it's a good contemplation practice to look at. If I expect this person from someone else, do I possess those same qualities? Because I'll tell you, I have a freedom in partnership. So I feel very free. I'm very centered. I love my own company. I love my solitude. So when I partner with someone, there should be an ease and a flow because I give that person freedom to be who they are because that's what I want. I want freedom to be who I am. And so for me, a restrictive type of relationship where someone is trying to control who I am, control my behavior, it won't work for me. It really doesn't work for anyone, but there's a dysfunction regarding relationships that I just kind of watch unfold. It's not healthy. So the more that you can get clear and centered and loving who you are as a person and expressing that love to the world and allowing people to be who they are, if you can allow people to be who they are and then decide whether or not that fits with what you want or your lifestyle, there's just enormous freedom. And there's billions of people on the planet. So the thought that maybe you had a breakup and the thought that you'll never find someone else like that, you made that up. There's billions of people on the planet. Do you mean to tell me that you can't find a suitable partner when there's literally billions of people on the planet? It's not logical. So it's more about accepting each moment as it is, being happy where you are. The other spin on this is, have you ever noticed when you are in a relationship? I notice this all the time. And I work with people. I do readings. I do energy healing. And I've been studying relationships, my own relationships. I've had so many dysfunctional relationships that I've had to grow through. And so I'm just sharing. And if this doesn't resonate with you, that's okay. Just click off, move on. I'm not here to argue. I'm just sharing with you a different perspective based on what I've learned through working with clients and my own life and all of that. So have you ever noticed that people, when they're in a relationship, some people, and just look at this, because this has happened to me, you're in the wrong relationship or you're feeling the squeeze of a relationship where you think, oh my gosh, I really miss just when I was single and I didn't have to deal with this. Have you ever had that happen? I have. And then flip it, you're single. So people then when they're single, and I've had this happen, you know, decades ago before I learned all the things I'm sharing with you now. You're single and then you're longing for a relationship, wishing you were in a relationship. The point is, it goes back to your mindfulness practice. Be here now. You are at the perfect place. You're in the right place right now. And you have the power to shift yourself and change and align with what you want. You want to shift it to an empowering perspective so that you're not sulking and feeling like a victim because you aren't a victim. You're not a victim. I understand people can be victimized, but we're more powerful than we realize. And that's my whole point. So when you're trying to create something, it's okay. Put the energy out there, do the work, but release it. The attachment to the outcome. Releasing the attachment to the outcome releases that desperate energy. And just enjoy the day. I mean, come on, we're alive. We have one another. We can get on the internet. We can connect to each other. We have the power to meet people. We have the power to brighten people's days. We have the power to brighten our own day. You know, what is it that you really want today? What is it that your body needs? What is it that your soul needs? You can tune in, and we'll do this in our healing today. You just tune in and say, what do I really want today? What do I really need? A lot of time for me, it's just rest, doing things that fuel me. Exercising. You know, I'm a really simple person. It really doesn't take much to fulfill me and make me happy. I like connection. I like authenticity. For someone to just be authentic and vulnerable and for me to have the space to do that back means a ton to me. It's very deeply fulfilling for me. So a lot of times it's not that much. So, and if you're healing from a heartbreak, I know that's hard and you have to move through the emotions. You've got to feel it to heal it. And we all know that. And I know it's not the happiest, most joyful experience because I know I've been through it many times, but knowing that you will get through this and there's light on the other side. And this is just part of living, you know, we're hardwired for survival. We're hardwired when we come in to like get over these challenges and you can get through it. So if that's the case, nurture yourself today. What do you really need? You know, is it time to speak with a loved one? Is it, you know, comforting? Do you need to just kind of lay down and relax? Like, what is it that you need? That's my whole point. Meet your own needs. When you meet your own needs, then you meet other people, whatever they give is just extra and it's for the overflow, but you're content and whole within yourself. And then it's just easy breezy. At least that's been my experience. So I just wanted to share that with you today. And I'm happy to spend a little bit of Valentine's Day here with you today because I appreciate you. And my whole point of creating these podcasts, this channel, everything that I do is just to share what I've learned in hopes of helping you along your path, because people have helped me along my path. I'm grateful for everyone who podcasts and authors that I can learn from and people who choose to share their experiences that I can relate to and I can feel validated and seen. You know, that's the other part of it. When we share with one another, people feel validated and, hey, I felt like that too. I thought I was the only one. So it's really nice to share to let you know, no, you're not the only one, but here's how I got through it. You know, it helps to lend a helping hand, pull people up out of the pit and let them know I made it and you can make it too. And I shifted this and you can shift it too. And so that's really all I wanted to share. So let's go into a healing. And during this healing, ask your body, and I'll prompt you, ask your body, what do I really need today? So just be prepared for that. And you can just go ahead and get ready and start to focus on your breathing and uncross your arms and legs and just receive the divine love that I'm going to allow to come through me. And now is the perfect time to just tune in, drop into your heart center, and just listen to your body's messages. So what do I need right now? Just ask yourself, what do I need right now? What do I want right now? What do I really want right now? Okay, and so it is. Well, I hope you do something really special for yourself and something to pass it on to others. And as I said, it can be anything, anything that expands your heart chakra, puts you in alignment, and helps you participate in making the world a happier place and letting life know and others know how much you are in gratitude and appreciation. So that is all I have. I want to wish you a beautiful week. Take care. Bye-bye.